Okay. Hier. Sonny's family, wat is het? Ja.
What's shaking?
She's fast. But I told her no daughter of mine is going out dressed like some hussy.
Oh, cops.
I do not fucking like this.
Shit. Never mind.
whole shakedown crew's just gone. Fuck.
Ah, shit. That explains the thing with little Anthony this morning.
What'd Sonny Blue do this time?
Little Anthony walks in, says good morning. Sonny goes off, beats him with the flat end of a meat hook. Asked Anthony if it was a good morning now.
God damn.
We need to get a handle on what's been going on before Sonny kills the rest of us.
Funny part is, I just talked to Greco a couple days back. Dumb motherfucker didn't see it coming.
And that's why this here is the perfect gig. Low stress, decent pay.
You don't want something better? I mean, Greco was a fuck up. But he had ambition. You have to respect that.
Hell, in this business, this life, you keep your head down or you lose it. That right there is the real moral of the story.
Yeah, come here. Ah, shit.
It's a bowl of fucking cherries.
Huh? Okay, that was close.
Come on!
Look what the cat drug is!
will leave what's left of you to my dogs!
To worry about to get flanked from below, because I killed everyone below.
Hey, he's over here. He killed another one of ours.
You got nowhere to go. I gotta find this asshole myself.
That you, son of a bitch? Over there! Shoot him! Stop! Taking a shot!
Let me get the money first.
Shit, shit! This ain't right. Can't be happening.
Now, to do this.
You could be the bratwurst king in New Bordeaux if you work for me. How's that sound, Sonny?
Sure. I kinda like working here anyway.
Good. Burke's boys are gonna reach out.
Ah, there isn't collectible there. Damn it.
Slaughterhouse is clear. Send your people.
Hey, don't worry about the bodies. My boys will know what to do about them. If we can retake the distillery, that fat fucking Barbieri won't have anywhere else to go.
Okay.
Thomas Burke came to the States as a boy when his father fled Ireland, likely because of his involvement in the Irish Civil War. After his father died of a heart attack, Burke started running booze to support himself. I mean, he turned bootlegging into an entire industry, and Sal Marcano took notice. Burke worked his way up the ranks, but could never be made because he wasn't Italian.
Before... Perkson, fine. Oh, nice.
Mr. Clay, Good to have this back in our hands.
Oh, that looks stacks here. Oh my god. The hell? Yo. Let's do it, I guess. Oh my god, why do they jump in front of the car? Let's do this. I don't want to rob the cops, man. I don't. Don't jump onto the street, you stupid. Holy shit, look how many guys.
Well, that's the good shit right there, boy. Job for me.
One jar of high octane coming up.
Turpentine.
Settle down, son. It gives a shine that little kid.
Holy shit! He's over here! Fuck that boy!
Move!
Get your head down! Get fucked! You're gonna get flagged, cocksucker! Let me see you!
Yeah. Let's go back. Nice.
Bevis can't be happy about what you've been doing to the distilleries. You got Carl's attention. He's back at the Sweetwater Distillery.
Any idea how he'll react when I go in there?
He's bug shit crazy swamp people. How do you think he'll react? Still, might be worth keeping him around. No one knows the bayou like he does.
Owe you one for this, Nikki.
Damn right you do. Bevis is waiting for you. Real interested to see how you handle him.
Of course, he goes to the right, stupid cop. What? Not so many guards, what?
Bug up your ass. Most of that shine we lost belonged to us.
You try and pour something on Barbieri. That dead-eyed fucker will find out. Meaning he'll come after not just you and me, but Ma, Penny, kids, everybody. Now, we gotta get ahead of this.
You could always put it on bike. Quit the thump.
No, dipshit. is all going on you.
Thank you.
Huh? Fuck you and fuck Burke.
You talk too much. Emptied out the distillery. It's primed and ready for your boys.
Hope's still standing. My boys are on the way. Everything's in place. The butcher's on his way. Time to put that rabid dog down.
Lincoln Clay convinced Thomas Burke, Vito Scaletta, and the woman known as Cassandra to work together.
He called a sit-down. He told them to meet him at an old plantation house in the bayou. When he had them all in the same room, he laid out how they were going to take down Marcano. Lincoln could be very persuasive.
You know what? Let's do that in the next video. So I'll see you guys then. Bye.